So a lot of people are struggling with their online marketing. And the main reason for that is because they don't have a strategy. Okay, that's the main reason. But if they do have a strategy, it's usually tied up in all these different tactics and they try to overcomplicate things. When what they really need to do is look at what is working in the physical world. They need to look at how people like to be spoken to. They need to look at how they want to be marketed to and just apply some common sense to their marketing. Okay? Let me give you an example of how we can compare what works in the physical world and how we aren't really doing that very well in the online world, most of us anyway, okay? So let's imagine that you're working on your laptop, you've had the laptop for a few years, you know you're gonna need a new one soon, it's working now, but you know you're gonna need a new one, okay? And so I know when I work on my laptop, I usually have the radio on, okay? So as you're working on your laptop, you hear some radio commercials and they're talking about this new laptop that has like facial recognition software and it's absolutely bomb-proof when it comes to viruses and, you know, it's just got all these amazing, ridiculous, cool features, okay? And you're like, wow, that sounds really cool. But what if that radio ad failed to tell you where you could buy that laptop? That'd be a pretty weak ad, wouldn't it? And this is what a lot of people are doing with their blogs, okay? They've got these amazing blogs, they give all this information, they educate the crap out of people, but they don't give those people the opportunity to purchase, okay? And that's a big gap in the marketing, right? They know they need to educate, they know they need to inform their people, their people need to know, like, and trust them, but they're not giving them the opportunity to buy, okay? And so that's what a lot of people are doing with their blogs. They're providing tremendous education, but they're not giving them the opportunity to purchase. Okay, and that can be very frustrating. So that's the one part. So that's sort of a message to people who have blogs and are trying to use their blogs to market their business. All right, so let's say you do know where this laptop is being sold. It's being sold at this department store. Let's call it Best Buy. Okay, let's say Best Buy is selling this super cool laptop. All right, so you're like, you know what, it's time, I'm gonna buy that laptop. And so you head to Best Buy, all right? You park, it's a full parking lot, you park near the back, and then as you're walking, there's a guy, and he's got his car, and he opens his trunk, and he's like, dude, do you want, you know, this laptop? And it's the laptop you're looking for. And it's like $200 less than you know that it's being sold for in the store. So what do you do? Do you buy the laptop from this guy in his car? He told you it's got like a 5-year warranty and all you have to do is come back to the parking lot and he'll be parked with his car there every day for the next 5 years. So if you ever have any troubles with it, you can just bring it back and he'll be parked there with his trunk open. So it's $200 less to get it from this guy with his open trunk. Or you can go in the store and buy it there for $200 more. Now, where are you probably gonna buy it? Now, for me, something like a laptop, I'm probably gonna buy it in the store because I expect my laptops to break, I expect them to need service, and I wanna know that that store is gonna be there when my laptop breaks down. Now, if I was gonna buy an axe or a shovel or something that I don't expect is gonna need warranted, then I might buy it from the trunk of the car. But the laptop I'm gonna buy from the store. And why? Because that store has just got a lot more credibility, right? Best Buy, it's a national chain. There's like four of them in Ottawa. So I know if something goes wrong with that laptop, I can return it there. And so what that guy with his open trunk, that's kind of like a funnel, in my opinion, right? Like there's this guy, he just sort of drives up, he presents you with an offer, and he says he's gonna be around tomorrow, but you don't know. And that's what a lot of people are doing with their funnels, right? They throw up an ad, they throw up an offer, it sounds really cool, but the credibility isn't there. If I've never heard of you before, it's gonna be pretty tough for you to make that sale for me, all right? Now let's flip it a little bit, all right? Let's say that you see the guy with the laptop in his trunk and you start to walk away. You're like, no, I'm gonna go and buy it from a brick and mortar. He's like, oh, wait, you know what? I actually have a brick and mortar. My store is called, I don't think they exist in Canada anymore, but I own Future Shop. And so like we've got Future Shop locations all over North America. Oh, well, that's a little bit different, right? If you can prove to me that, you know, you own Future Shop and you've got a brick and mortar backing up your car trunk sale, then that's going to be a little bit different. So if he says, you know what, yeah, I'm just selling this out of my car, we're going head to head against Best Buy, and I know they're the same company, but this is a story, okay? So he says, let's say, like, yeah, we're going head to head against Best Buy, and so I'm just here, you know, trying to steal clients from those guys, right? So it's like, okay, but if you have any trouble with your laptop, just bring it in any future shop location, and we'll take care of it for you. Well, it's $200 less. They've got the credibility of the brick and mortar. Now he has a lot better opportunity to make that sale. And so this is kind of like a funnel that also has a website, all right? The brick and mortar, that's kind of like a website, right? I know you could throw up a website, you know, in a couple hours, couple days, but usually the people with websites have a lot more information, right? And so let's go to that. Let's say you go into the store. Let's say you go into Best Buy and there's the laptop there, right? The laptop's there, it's everything you want, but it's expensive. And you're like, oh man, I wonder if it's gonna go on sale. I wonder, you know, if Future Shop has it for less money. I wonder if you can buy it at Costco. I wonder, you know, if you can get it somewhere else. So you might look at it at Best Buy, you might check it all out. And then you're like, yeah, okay, I think I wanna buy this eventually. But you're gonna leave, right? Because there's no urgency to buy it right now. And that's what most websites do. All right. Again, so they give you information, maybe they give you the opportunity to buy, but there's no urgency. So that's where the funnel comes in. And I don't know if Kmart still exists, but I remember shopping at Kmart with my parents when I was a kid. And they always had these blue light specials pop up, right? So attention shoppers, there's a blue light special in the candy section. You know, buy like 42 Mars bars for only $5, you know, something like that. So that blue light special that exists at Kmart, that's your funnel. So when somebody comes into your website, right, sure they could look around and check stuff out, but what if you incorporated a funnel with that, all right? And the funnel is the blue light special. You get this pop-up that says, hey, you know what, you're looking at this laptop. If you buy this laptop in the next, you know, 30 minutes, then, you know, we'll give you a couple hundred bucks off. Or another thing, you know, you want more information on this laptop, you want to know why facial recognition is so important, give me your email and I'll give you this free report on why facial recognition is so important for you to have now in your laptops. So now I might not have made the sale, but now I've got them on my list and I can retarget them and I can talk to them about, you know, other offers and other urgency specials, right? So all that to say that the people, the businesses that succeed online, they have three things going for them, right? They've got a radio ad or some sort of advertisement, this is what we call paid traffic, right? They have some way to educate, cold traffic, tell them about their business, about their offer, and what they can provide, right? So they've got that, but then they also have, you know, call to action in that radio ad, in that magazine ad, whatever. It's like call to action, go to my funnel, go to my website, check things out, right? So then you go to the store. The website, that gives you the credibility that you need, that you're not just a fly-by-night funnel maker, that you're not here today, gone tomorrow. The website, you know, it gives you an anchor. The website has, you know, the About Us page. It tells you who you are, why you do what you do. It's got the testimonials. It's got a way to contact you. It's got like a phone number. It's got a contact form. So people know you're a real guy and you're not just, again, a fly-by-night, here today, gone tomorrow funnel builder, right? But I'm not knocking funnels. You got to have that funnel because that's where the urgency comes in. So when they're in your website or they're at your store, then they know that they need to buy now or you have the opportunity to get their contact information so you could talk to them at a future date. All right, so it's those three things that if you really want to succeed online, because this is what works in the physical world, you need you need an ad, of course, but you also, like, the blog gives so much information, and a blog also gives credibility, right? If you keep providing content and content and content with calls to action, calls to action, calls to action, then people are going to come back and they're going to read your stuff, but if that call to action is always there, at one point they're going to click on that, they're going to go to your, wherever you direct them, your funnel or your website or what have you, and they're going to have that opportunity to buy what you're selling. All right. So you need, so it's great to have that blog to stay in front of people, to provide them with education. You're going to want to have a website. That's your anchor. That shows that you're serious about your business. That shows that you have an established business, right? And then you need that funnel for the urgency, all right? For the scarcity, to get that contact information, to provide them with an amazing offer and to get the sale, all right? So think about that next time you put up a funnel with like, click here to get my three secrets on weight loss. You know, who are you? You know, why should I trust you? Why should I give you my email? You're just going to sell it to a bunch of, you know, email spamming people. And, you know, I don't need that in my life. So anyways, that's what you want to think about. I know it sounds like a lot more work, but the thing is succeeding in business is work. You've got to do the work. You've got to make a name for yourself. You've got to establish your credibility online before you're going to have the success that you really want. All right. If you like this video, if you have any comments, leave them below. And also, don't forget to subscribe to my channel because it's a really cool channel. All right. Thanks, everyone. And we'll talk to you in the next video. Bye-bye.